afternoon. Good afternoon, teachers in the Europass community. It is so nice to be with you again on our weekly Wednesday Europass Talks. And I'm happy that you're here with us. I am today, as I mentioned to you last week we talked about the four C's. And this week, I have a special guest. I have a special guest who is coming from the Hellenic Mediterranean University in Greece. And he is a professor there, and I will allow him to introduce himself. But first, I wanted to make sure that I said hello to everyone. I hope you're having a good week so far. And the weather is getting nice. And this week I am doing a face-to-face course in Europass, and I am so excited. And I'm really looking forward to being able to welcome a lot of teachers from the Europass community back in Florence, or in Berlin, in Dublin, in Barcelona, in any one of our locations. And so today, we are going to talk to my friend Kostas, okay? Kostas, and he is going to talk to us a bit about time management. Now, before I get started, I was wondering if people, if the teachers that are watching, do you have any difficulties with time management? Please write in the chat box. From 1 to 10, 1 means that you have no problem. 10 means you have a lot of problems. So on a scale from 1 to 10, how big is your time management problem in your opinion? Okay. I'll be curious to see if you write anything for me. All right. Now I would like to bring in Kostas.
Hello.
Oh, there you are.
Hi, Susan. Good afternoon from Crete in Greece. The weather here is fantastic. We are already on the beach and the summer is here. And thank you very much for this invitation. I will try to help you by describing the mistakes that I'm doing. Susan has introduced me, I am a teacher in the university. I'm regarding the scale from 1 to 10, I'm suffering with 10.
So 10.
I will try. My background is laser physics. My research is in laser physics and new materials. I love teaching, first of all. Apart, I love, you know, the research that we are doing here in Crete. And I will be very happy to share with you my experiences and more than this, my mistakes and what I'm doing in order to solve my mistakes or to handle my mistakes.
So for anyone who's just joined us, I asked for you to write in the chat box, how big is your time management problem on a scale from 1 to 10? 1 means that you have no problems. 10 means you have big problems. Okay. And I see that we do have Maria Grazia Convertino, who said she's a 5. And I'd say, hey, maybe she should come and talk to us.
Exactly.
5 is pretty good.
Instead of me, that I'm suffering with 10.
I mean, Kostas, my first question is, why is time management so hard? Why is it so hard for us to manage our time?
In my opinion, and especially as we are moving towards the digitalization of everything, you know, I mean, we commit ourselves to many things because of the digitalization. So to have time management is so important, in first of all, in order to manage your well-being. Second, in order to handle and protect your reputation as a professional.
Wait, this is interesting. Mm-hmm. Tell me about this. You want to have good time management in order to manage and protect your reputation as a professional.
Exactly. Huh. This is very important because usually we are ambitious. We would like to do a lot of things. The digital tools helps us to do a lot of things. At the same time, we can contact and we can communicate with everyone within Europe, beyond Europe, within Greece, beyond Greece in a few milliseconds. And this does not give us the time to think about how much time it will take to, for us to travel from one place to another. We think that we can do things and we learn ourselves. It's like machine learning. We are learning ourselves that we can do a lot of things in within a few, within a short period of time. And this is a very big trap. We used to say yes to everything in order to promote, to address our, let's say, ambitions and to achieve many, many targets within a very short period of time. I think this is the biggest trap, to say yes to a lot of things because of the digitalization of our life.
If
you say yes and you are not going to do the things, the people that don't know you, they can characterize you like a person that you are not responsible of your saying. So this is a very big trap that we should be very careful. And I'm suffering from this, I have to say.
And tell us about this suffering. What's happening with you?
I mean, if you are exposed to a lot of projects, if you are exposed to a lot of activities, because, of course, all of us, we are teachers and we love our job, then you should do the things that you're saying. So if you have placed too many, how can I say, this is at the same, on the same table, I mean, the time is limited. You have just 24 hours, you need to sleep at least, and sleeping is very important regarding your time management and in order to perform. And if you have too many commitments, you know, some of the commitments at the end of the day, they are not going to be implemented to the standards that you have.
And that would be that really can make a person feel very ashamed. It's something that can have a big impact on their self-esteem.
Exactly. And I'm not going to say ashamed, but of course, you know, the people, they will expect from you different kind of quality of deliverance. Of course, you are going to do the best that you can, but it's very hard if you have too many things and a lot of deadlines, especially every day. You cannot compensate, you know, with this pressure. So it's not only your reputation, it's also your health. You are under stress all the time, and this does not allow you to perform. So time management helps from the well-being for your personal life, to devote some time to your family and to the people that are around you, which is the most important things that we have on our life, to pay the specific amount of attention, you know, to your students, to your people that you are collaborate with. So it's more than, you know, a soft skill. It's like a key soft skill, I will say, for the today's life.
And I'm looking at some of the comments, right? And we have some people saying that they are an 8, a 7, a 6. And then we have someone who says, I never have time. And so I think that this is, do you think that this is a particularly big problem in academia, with teachers, with students? Mm-hmm. Have you noticed that this is something that, because we are also in a helping profession. So we teach oftentimes because we really like to help. We want to be involved. We want to make a difference. And then this is part of what happens when we say yes to many things. Mm-hmm. And then of course, with the pandemic, now we don't even have those natural boundaries between work and our homes and our private life. Mm-hmm. And so what can we do, Kostas? What do you think would be some good tips for our teachers?
So first of all, you know, what we should do, and this is the first thing that, you know, I'm trying to train myself as well, is like to learn no, to learn to say no. I mean, this is not a bad thing to do. It actually, it's like a very honest thing to do. If you don't want, for example, to say directly no to a collaboration that it seems very promising, but because of lack of time, you cannot be committed right now, say that, you know, I'm going to think it, I'm going to, we can collaborate a little bit later on. I mean, try to avoid in a polite way. But, you know, the first thing is like to learn to say no. Second thing is like, and very important thing is like to prioritize. So do the things that, you know, the deadlines are very close, and also the impact of your actions, you know, are on the highest level. So do the things that they are coming first, and do the things that they have the highest impact on you. There is like a if I was using, you know, like, you know, a presentation, there are, you know, you can prioritize your stuff using this kind of square with urgent, not urgent, and important and non-important. So we have urgent and important are the things that we should place, that we should do it today, are things that they are important but not urgent, so we can replay, we can place them a little bit later, are the things that they are important, they are urgent but not important, so we can allocate this to one of our colleagues, and also are the things that are non-important and not urgent, which are things that we should erase from our list.
For example, what would you erase from your list?
I will erase the things that, you know, as I said, that is not urgent and not important for me. So this is something that depends on each one of us. For example, for me, right now, I'm not placing myself in a hole, let's say, to do administration tasks that I can avoid. I have some plans regarding my career, and these are the important and urgent things that I want to do. And, you know, also I am allocating to my PhD students the things are important but not urgent right now. So, I mean, prioritization is something that depends on each one of us. I cannot, you know, say how to prioritize, even though that, you know, this kind of square helps you to do it, you know, in a daily base or in a weekly base. So in the weekend, try to prioritize the things that you should do or the things that you can allocate to other people. And learn to say no. So learn to say no and, you know, prioritize your tasks.
You know, it's so interesting that you're talking about learning to say no. I was talking about this with the teachers I have in my course this week. And I was talking about it in terms of healthy boundaries, where we have to think about at any given moment in our lives, what is possible for us and what is not possible. What I can do and what I can't do. And the interesting thing is that when you establish boundaries, sometimes there are people that are not happy with your boundaries because they are used to you saying yes. And we were talking today about how important it is to be able to, if you have the impulse to say yes, to know that you have that impulse and to breathe and perhaps say to the person, thank you so much for thinking of me. I am going to sleep on it and I will give you an answer tomorrow. Especially for people who tend to say yes. They like everything or they feel responsible. They feel a great sense of duty. I see, for example, one of the teachers wrote, the word duty in a broader sense is what matters in our teaching profession, as we tend to devote time to our students instead of ourselves because we want to offer. Yes. And these boundaries, there's a fantastic quote by Brené Brown, who is a social scientist in the United States. And she says that when she started thinking about her boundaries, she said, I realized maybe I'm not as sweet as I was before, but I am much more loving. Because she said, I would rather give what I can give with my whole heart instead of giving what I don't have and being angry and resentful.
This is totally true. And I will say, and I will advise the people that, you know, the respect from the others comes as a function of time. So probably at the beginning, someone, and this is something that it happened to me. Whenever someone said to me, no, I cannot do it right now, I said like, oh, he does not like me, or he does not want to be committed, or he's lazy. I was thinking, you know, I had some strange thoughts, but this is not true. At the end of the day, I'm respecting the people that they say no because they are responsible of what do they say. So it's better to provide, you know, less things of high quality. It's like publications than a lot of things of low quality. So at the end of the day, as I'm giving an example of publications because I'm coming from the university point of view, it's not the number of publications that you should have, but the number of citations that your work will take. So this reflects the quality. So if you would like them to be respected, at the end of the day, when you think that you cannot commit it, say no. And it's not only this. Before we mentioned about time management and this kind of square, important, non-important, urgent, and non-urgent, always try to do an over-budgeting of your time. So never say that, oh, I mean, I have to write this abstract for a conference or for a presentation. It will take for me like 150 words, like half an hour. It will never take you half an hour. Just say 20% more than a half an hour. Say 45 minutes. And this should be depicted on your diary. So another tip is like to keep a diary, just a single diary. We are living in digital work, so always I have my smartphones and I have my diary over there, and I'm trying to over budget my time. Mm. I cannot manage, but I'm doing this. So I'm fixing on my daily diary, you know, like specific time that a task that I have to do, it takes. Always I'm a little bit over budgeting this. And if I finish earlier, it's better for my break. So to take breaks also are important for your performance. So over budgeting, in this case, it's very helpful.
Exactly. Not with our wallets, but with our time.
It depends on your position.
And I mean, so what kinds of, what do you find are the biggest problems that we talked about the fact that people have trouble saying no. And then what do you find are some big problems with some teachers and also the students? Like, how is it that they are having such difficulty? Like, what could they possibly do once they have prioritized and once they have made sure that they've allotted enough time to do something? Is there some type of a method that they could use, something that would actually give them some structure to it?
So what I can say is, like, first of all, you know, prioritization and blocking your diary is very, diary, blocking your slots on your diary is very important. Use only one diary, either is an electronic one, or if you are old guy like me, like keeping your diary, like, you know, on your notebook, but yeah, keep, just have only one. Time management and performance also has to do with breaks. So you should take some breaks in order to concentrate, to refocus yourself in order to perform. So another approach is this Pomodoro. I don't know if you are familiar with this. It's like the Pomodoro technique. I mean, you can find it, you know, it's a free application that you can install it in your smartphone, like to work for 25 minutes, be focused 5 minutes break. And then when you complete it for 25 slots, then you can have a bigger break of 20 minutes. This helps you to think and perform.
Pomodoro technique. I'm writing it in the comments. Mm-hmm. And Kostas, I have to ask you though, how is it that you have developed such a reputation for being the time management guru? I have seen you I have been invited to give talks about, you know, the things that I'm interested in, and I found you giving talks about time management. How did this happen?
I think that, you know, I'm one of your people in your audience. I mean, I'm doing mistakes, so I'm trying to work with my mistakes. So this is like a scholar, any teacher what is doing. We are students at the same time, so we are learning from our mistakes. So using my mistakes and using my experience, what I'm doing mistake, I'm trying, you know, to contribute to the rest of the people. So I'm not going to consider myself a guru, but, you know, probably I'm a guru of my mistakes. So I'm trying to advise and discuss with the people what mistakes I'm doing, and then, you know, exchanging opinions and exchanging policies in order to correct what we are doing mistakes.
And so tell me about, you know, you were talking about sleep being very important.
Okay.
Yeah. And you know, people are not sleeping, and they're also spending a lot of time, instead of falling asleep, they're scrolling their phones, and, you know, they're spending a lot of time on social media, and oftentimes they don't realize how much time.
Mm-hmm. This is very important. When you would like to perform and you would like to have to do your work, like, it's better, you know, like, to close the door of your office, to be focused on what are you doing. It's better to switch off any alerts that you have on your computer or on your iPhone or your smartphone. Be focused and use this Pomodoro technique, like 25 minutes, work very, very well, and you will see that this will help you a lot. I mean, these distractions that we have around us, like all the alerts coming from our computers or from our smartphones, are things that destroy our time management. So instead of doing something that it will take half an hour, we're doing something that it will take an hour or an hour and a half, because we are jumping from one point to another. So this is something else that we should avoid, multitasking. So try during the prioritization of your tasks to prioritize the things that you know, are under the same category for an exam. Like in the lunch, after the lunch break, spend an hour for your emails. This is like an allocated time, a time slot for you to do this task. Don't try at the same time that you are replying an email, wow, I have to read this because tomorrow I have this presentation. Try to be focused on the things that you are doing, trying to a little bit over budget your time. One day it has like 12 hours. Try to sleep, because if you are tired, you are not performing, and you are not, the things that you have placed on the table takes more time than it should be.
That is an enormous thing. What you just said about deciding, when am I going to answer my emails? When am I going to prepare my lessons? When am I going to grade? Because we get ding, and there's all the different, all the notifications for all the different apps we have, and they make different sounds, and it's a compulsion. Mm-hmm. It is a compulsion for us to look. And it could be very helpful to think of it in terms of, okay, no one, especially for it tends to be the multitasking is a thing that teachers do, and without wanting to gender stereotype, but it does tend to be a bit more of a female problem. That we are used to keeping our eyes on many different things. And I think during the pandemic, in some ways, it maybe got worse because lots of people were working from home and they had children at home who were also trying to do remote learning. And at the same time, you're stirring the pasta and, you know, and I think this idea that we take off those notifications. What do you think of on your smartphone? I found that I could also limit the amount of time that I'm on certain apps. And that at a certain point, my phone says, you have used up all of the time for the day. And then I have to make a conscious decision. Do I want to ignore that? Or am I going to say, okay.
In my case, what I'm doing is like when I would like to get focused, I'm switching off my mobile phone. So whoever would like to find me, they will find me. Actually, you know, the people are like, we are like machine, we are like robots. We are learning from habit. So the people, they know that if my mobile phone is off, now they know that they can contact with me little bit later on. So okay. I will say, switch off your mobile phones. The people, if there is an urgent way, there are different ways to communicate with you. I can understand, what did you say, that during the pandemic we used to stay in the same office or in the same room with to cook, to eat, to sleep, and also to work. These are, you know, the distraction parameters are numerous around us. But if we would like to have a time to perform, because this is time management, it's like to be efficient, not busy. A lot of people, they used to say, like, I'm busy, busy, busy. Busy means that you don't have good time management. All of us were busy. And that we should be efficient. Efficient. Money is like efficiency. Time management has to do with efficiency. So if you have a good time management, you're efficient. This is the way that you should think. If you think that you cannot perform, or if you go to sleep and you start to say, oh, I forgot this, I forgot that, I forgot the other thing, this means that your time management it sucks. So it's better for you to make some correction.
Yes. Yes. This idea that you go to bed and then, right? And then you fling the covers off. And then next thing you know, you're turning the computer back on because you're like, I forgot to answer that email.
I found out that if you are under such a stress conditions, but this can be through your email, you know, that we have stress from the amount of emails that we have answered and we are not able to answer. So I will say to make a stop, say like, you know, for the next week, I will do this, categorize my stuff, what I have to do in the same categories, allocate some time, and then you will see as the time passes, if you are coherent and if you are, let's say, well-organized and you keep your time management in a good level, you are going to feel much better.
You're going to feel less stressed and you're going to feel more competent, like a bit more even like in control of your life.
Because you will become more efficient. And, you know, efficiency has to do with this. You are controlling your life, you are efficient and you are performing. And then at the same time, this means, this is a necessity. You are feeling well. So this is very important, the well-being. If you are under stress, or if you are tired, or if you are not sleeping well, then you are aggressive and you are destroying your collaboration. This is very important to remember. And try to avoid the word busy, all right? If you are busy, your time management, as I said before, is very bad.
You know, it's interesting. That was something that really struck me the first time you and I met, is when you said, if you go around saying you're busy, then you have a problem. And right. I was the queen. I was the queen of busy. Yes. Before the pandemic, oh, busy, 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 and I had to go here. And it was almost a source of pride, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Right? It was like a badge of honor. I'm busy. And, you know, busy means, you know, I don't know, maybe in my distorted view of it, it meant, you know, that I was doing things, that I was successful in what I was doing. But actually, when the pandemic came, can I tell you a secret? Just between you and me, no one can hear us. When the pandemic came, I said, oh, really? You mean I can stop for like a few? Of course, then I stopped for a long time, but it was a real big wake up moment for me. And, you know, how about for you, Kostas? What would you say was there a certain episode or an event that really made you say, enough? I have to get my time management under control. What was one of your biggest issues?
My biggest issues is like when I have vacations and I cannot stop thinking of the work. So this is like one of the things that, you know, makes me feel bad, makes me feel stressed, and makes me feel uncomfortable with myself and also with the people around me. So yes. When lately, you know, the last years, you know, I found myself, I was not respecting my weekends. I was not respecting the people around me. I was only thinking about the work. So I could not even read about my book. I read my newspaper, spend time, you know, for my physical condition. And this makes you, you know, to feel that you're reaching, you know, a borderline. And if you reach this borderline, something should be changed. Otherwise, I mean, you're going to face health issues as well. Because, you know, if the stress and if you're not sleeping, it takes, you know, a long, long time. For sure, you're going to have a negative impact to your health. So yeah. I advise the people do not reach this point. From the moment that they will feel stressed, start to say no, plan your time, prioritize your time, and be efficient. Become an efficient professional means that you have the time to enjoy your life. You have the time to go to the gym. You have the time to read your book. And at the same time, you are a good professional. You are doing the tasks that I have been assigned or you are responsible of. Mm-hmm. Don't try, you know, to destroy this balance, because if you start to destroy this balance, then it will come against you sooner or later.
Yes, at some point, life, we say, presents you the bill, you know, and either you are starting to have some type of a health problem or a relational problem, because, you know, you might feel like you're physically present with, for example, the people who are really important to you, but if you don't realize that you are constantly lifting your phone and checking and checking and checking compulsively, you're not really there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the people around you, they notice. And then, you know, the other thing is, you know, our children are watching.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I will give you an example, like, based on what did you say. Like, we can see right now, you know, the kids, you know, they are always in front of an iPad or in a smartphone, and they are isolated between them. They cannot speak. They cannot interact. The same happens if you have a bad management, a time management as a professional. Mm-hmm. Probably at the beginning, the people, they will say, oh, he's very busy or she's very busy. But at the end of the day, this means that they cannot collaborate with you. So if you are keeping busy and you don't say no, or when you say yes, it's yes, at the end of the day, you are going to be isolated.
Yes.
So try time management. This reflects to the reputation and also for collaboration. Try to have a good time management in order to have more people around you in your personal life, but also in your professional life.
Fantastic. I mean, I'm seeing here that this is a lot of people are commenting. Maria Grazia says, efficiency is our contemporary prison of mind and being. And then we have here, Poppy says, workout happens because we live in a competitive environment and society, and we want to excel at everything, but this is impossible.
You cannot excel in everything. I mean, ancient Greeks, they used to say, I know what I don't know. So you cannot excel in everything. I mean, you are going to excel in the things that you are going to devote time and commitment, and you cannot be committed in everything. I mean, as I said to you, this is time of energy. I'm a physicist, so we have the conservation of energy. We have the conservation of time. You cannot generate time. You can generate money, but you cannot generate time. This is unfortunate. So to be focused and try to demonstrate your expertise and your commitment in specific topics. Don't try to excel in everything, because you will excel in nothing. This is my opinion, at least.
Well, I think you are saying something that's important for us to hear. I think it's important for us to be good role models for our students. And I think it's good to help our students already, even if we're talking about younger children, but just to understand the value of time and how, let's say, all of these in this digital world with all of these distractions, how we actually can damage our relationships and later on our reputation. And that is something that we all work very hard to preserve. And so it's a really good thing to think about today. Well, Kostas, I can't thank you enough. So how is your time management for our meeting today?
Oh, it's like, it sucks. At the same time, you know, I have to moderate another talks that we organize in the European University that I'm part of, and at the same time I should be here, but you know, I'm always glad to interact with people. I'm also glad to share my mistakes with the others and to try to communicate with the other people in order to excel in what we are doing. So there's not an issue about this.
Kostas, you're always organizing lots of things for the Erasmus projects and the different projects that you're involved in. Do you want to tell our teachers about the upcoming event that your university is organizing?
I mean, we organize a number of activities in order, as I told you, I'm a big fan of good teaching, because I believe good teaching, you know, is not only that we train the citizens of the future, but also that we train, you know, the future researchers. So I will say that the teaching is the most important things that we can do in a university or in a high school. Mm. So we organize every Wednesday at 4 o'clock CET, and I can share, you know, the links and the Zoom links with Susan, colloquia talks in teaching science. So people from all over the world, they teach us about the future trends, you know, of the European education, like starting from the digitalization of the education. Today we had the speaker from the European Commission that is speaking right now to us about the micro-credentials and how digitalization will affect the offered education, problem-based learning techniques. You know, we have Susan a lot of times invited in our activities to speak to us about soft skills, which are very important for a researcher. A researcher should have a critical thinking, should have a communication skills, his or she should have analytical thinking and conflict management. Mm-hmm. So every Wednesday from, you know, October until the end of June, we organize these colloquia talks in teaching science. So you are more than welcome to join and follow them. It's free, of course. I mean, you know, it's something that we are doing because we love our work. Every Friday, we organize, you know, colloquia talks in engineering. So if we have engineers here in lasers or in nanotechnology, we have invited talks from all over the world of experts that they are speaking to us about their work in nanotechnology and photonics. From the 24th of May to the 28th of May, we organize this school in smart technologies and smart cities. That Susan, you will be with us because the evenings, they are going to be devoted for the soft skills development. So your audience are more than welcome to join us. I will send
people can join these at any time. Anyone who's interested in these topics.
Anytime. So please, Susan, feel free to share, you know, the links. It could be the professionals or, you know, all the talks, it will be for under popular science in order the people to understand What does it mean a smart city, or what does it mean a smart technology? Starting from buildings, robotics, 3D printing, artificial intelligence in teaching. So we have plenty of talks, starting from 10 o'clock CET until 4 o'clock CET for a week. What else we're doing? I'm part of the European University of Athena. So nowadays, the universities, they try to make alliances. And in 3 years' time to operate as one university, this is like the flagship of the European Commission regarding the higher education. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, we are doing plenty of things.
And so I can understand why time management is fundamental, because you are a busy man. Well, no, you are an efficient man, and you are interested in a lot of things. And you, what I really enjoy about your work is your forward thinking, the fact that you are supporting young students and young researchers to try to, let's say, to be the best they can be and to face the challenges that we are facing. And the opportunities with a great sense of hope. And that's something that I really appreciate.
I will say to you, Susan, that you know, in Harvard, they used to say that the reputation of the universities comes from their graduate students. So like doing, you know, as a teacher, the best that we can in order to educate, you know, people better than us, or, you know, as good as we can, you know, this builds the reputation of our high school or the reputation of our university. So it's not a matter of student and teacher. It's like we have the duty to educate our teachers the best we can.
I love it. And with that, I want to thank you so much for taking the time to be here with me. And I can't wait to see you the week of May 21st.
From the 24th to the 28th of May.
And we will put that in the links for anyone that's interested. And thank you so much for being here with us today. And thanks for being a friend to the Europass community.
It was my pleasure. And I will do it with happiness anytime you will ask me.
Thank you, Kostas. Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
And thank you, teachers, for following us. I see that there was lots of activity in the chat box. I will answer everyone. And Kostas will also take a look later on. We will add some links in there for any additional information. Have a wonderful week, everyone. And be mindful of how you spend your time, because it's important for your well-being, for your reputation, and to avoid burnout. Okay.
Exactly.
Have a great week, everyone. We'll see you next week with another surprise speaker.
Bye.
Bye, Kostas. Take care.